Until I was 2 years old, the only language that was spoken at home was Mandarin Chinese. This quickly changed though when my big brother Alvin started attending preschool. You see, after a couple of classes, his preschool teacher became very frustrated because he couldn't understand any English. Alvin's teacher angrily called my parents and instructed them to stop speaking Chinese at home. And while it seemed like an okay idea at the time to my immigrant parents, my mom now says that that was the dumbest advice she's ever received in her entire life. And little did I know that this one conversation between my brother's preschool teacher and my mom will completely redirect the course of my life. You see, 20 years later, I'm completely fluent in English, but have very little Chinese language skills. Of course, this didn't stop people from assuming that I know how to speak Chinese. It was always the same. Chinese-speaking people would eagerly open a conversation with me in Chinese, expecting to have a pleasant dialogue in their native language. Because of this, I did have to learn one useful phrase, 我听不懂, which means I do not understand in Chinese. Then they would say something to the effect of,
I'm sorry, my Chinese, I'm so sorry.
I guess I am an American, or 美国人, as they say in Chinese, considering I was born and raised in America. Oddly enough though, the expectation of my identity is flipped when I'm around Americans. In their eyes, I'm more Asian than I am American.
Ah, so it's Stephen Lim. So you must be Chinese. So how would you say John in Chinese?
Growing up, I used to get questions like this all the time. It drove me nuts. It wasn't even that people, for some reason, always wanted to talk about where I was from, as if I didn't really belong in this country. But what cut deeper was that I knew that part of my cultural identity was lost, and that despite being ethnically Chinese, I can't speak the language. And well, I knew I was going to hear them say this.
Okay, so you're not Chinese-Chinese. You're like very, you're like a Twinkie, like yellow on the outside, white on the inside.
I know that the things that people say to me were never intended to hurt me, but not being able to speak Chinese has proven to be the hardest thing about being and looking Chinese. Frankly, I feel like a cat that barks. Because being Chinese, I look the part, but I sure don't play the part. And how I wish I could meet the expectations that come with having black hair and Asian facial features. And for that, there have been many times in my life where I desperately wished I was born white.
Guys, 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 how's this? 美国人.
Oh, that sounded really good.
Yeah, he even got the intonations right.
Yeah.
I can only imagine the reaction if I tried doing that myself.
Hey guys, how does it sound?
Learn Chinese. 美国人, 美国人. Does that sound right?
I mean, that was okay, but aren't you Chinese or something?
Yeah, but...
Do you want another cookie?
You see, even if I wanted to practice Chinese, I'd never be able to do it because it's too embarrassing. The few times I've braved to utter things in Chinese before, I've heard these very things said to me.
Your American accent is so bad.
Oh my gosh, just stop trying.
Your Chinese sounds like fart.
But wait, is it even my fault that I don't know Chinese? Isn't it my brother's preschool teacher who made me this way? Every New Year, my mother tells me to call my Nainai, which means grandma, and wish her a happy New Year. Every New Year, waves of shame and grief fill my heart. Beyond anything else in my cultural journey, this is the hardest. Only two generations separate Nainai and me, but that is more than enough to create a cultural and language gap that seems too large for me to overcome. When did it become an obligation instead of a joy to talk to the people that are supposed to be my family? In an attempt to recapture my identity, I recently started trying to learn a little bit of Chinese by taking Chinese classes, watching Chinese dramas, and practicing when I talk to Chinese people. It's not much, but I think it's a start. But does my ability to speak a language really define who I am? If I could speak Chinese, would that automatically make me Asian enough? Would it take away the shame I've experienced from feeling disconnected from my cultural roots? There is an inevitable loss that comes from immigration and generational gaps and language barriers, and I think it's okay to grieve that. But thank God, though, that my identity is not solely defined by the confines of race or my ability to speak Chinese. Thankfully, my identity comes from my creator, who loves me with no contingencies and no fine print. And so at the end of the day, I have no reason to be ashamed for how I was created or the way that I was brought up. Here we go. Hello? Grandma?
Hello?
Hello, Grandma?
This is...
This is Steven!
Steven?
Yeah, this is Steven.
Where
are you? 现在在我家。我的家。